Hi, I'm Alisha. I'm 17 years old and I'm an apprentice for EDF at Hinkley Point C. My dad told me that this apprenticeship was going, so I looked into it on the website and I thought it really suited my personality. So I applied for it. I got called up when I was in college saying that I had got the apprenticeship and I was so happy. I felt like everything was sorted out and I could just relax. I like living in Watchet because obviously we've got the harbour. So it's quite a nice area to live in. It's a nice, calm, enjoyable place to be.
I'm doing the Project Controls apprenticeship, which also includes a BTEC in engineering. Project Controls is keeping track of costs, schedule, risk and change. It ensures the project is kept on track and is delivered to budget and on time.
I'm Alicia's mentor on the Project Controls apprenticeship scheme. I've been in this industry for 35 years. It's really good for me to pass on my skills and knowledge, both in project controls and my nuclear experience, taking her through this exciting qualification with the ECITB.
So how has this big nuclear new build impacted on the local community? To find out how the project has benefited businesses, I've come to Dan's Engineering in Bridgewater. How did you get your apprenticeship?
My mate's mum got me a work experience here, and then I went back to East Bridgewater Community School for a year. Then I come back for my 3-year apprenticeship, and then I moved up to the office in the project design team.
How has the company benefited from Hinkley Point C?
It's helped grow the company massively. We got the extension we got on the end there, we helped with a grant. It's helped us bring in more of the work staff, we've got more apprentices on, and with the qualifications we got, it's helped us get bigger contracts from clients.
As well as local businesses, other community projects are benefiting from Hinkley Point C, like this one at Wyndham Village Hall in Bridgewater.
Wyndham Village is a thriving community village, and really 10 years ago there was a vision for the hall. The football club got involved at a really early stage because we didn't have pitches within the village. One stage, the project stalled. I think without EDF injecting £250,000 into the project, we wouldn't have the village hall.
One of my friends has actually applied for an apprenticeship with EDF now because I've convinced them it's really good, and I think a lot of people are quite jealous that I've got this opportunity, but I would like to stay with EDF and just go where I can with it. But I think it's a really good opportunity and there's lots of different areas that I can go into and it's quite broad. But yeah, I think it's really good.